Hi, I'm Ken Canopa here at FabTech here in Chicago, and I'm here with a group of esteemed colleagues to do a panel. I don't know if you were able to join us yesterday when we went live and revealed some new Rebel products, but our Rebel equipment isn't the only thing that's new here at ESAB, and I've gathered a group of experts here to talk about some of the other investments we've made in technology, because after all, a piece of equipment is nothing but a dust collector without the filler metal.
That's right.
That's absolutely right.
So, I've got with me here Lance Burnham from our Alcatec aluminum line of products. I got Danny Spackman. He's the godfather of our X series. And Neil Armstrong, who's heading up all of our North American product management, talking about all kinds of filler metal products. So let me start out with a few questions to ask you guys. Maybe let's share some things that we have going on that we don't really talk about. You know, we don't have lots of signage here about it, but it's important for people to know. You know, a lot of the questions that we get from people coming in are around aluminum and choosing the right product and metal compatibility with the base material, and it doesn't matter whether they're MIG welding or TIG welding, it's really all about compatibility of the metal base, isn't it?
That's right. You have to select the right filler for the base metal that you're welding on and for the application. And you have to look at things like sensitivity to hot crack, and the weld strength that you want, the ductility that you need in the weld. If you're going to anodize it after welding, the color match criteria. And there's several other things that you have to be aware of. But we have in our brochure, our technical brochure, we have in there a filler alloy guide. So depending on your application and what qualities you want in the weld itself, you choose your base metal. And if you're doing two different base metals, you can change up here and then go intersect with the chart and then look at the different characteristics that you're going to get. If there's no letter in there, it means it's not recommended. So all that's available through the Alcatec brochure.
But Alcatec's made it pretty simple to select the right filler metal, right, Lance?
That's right. Yeah, it's all right there in our brochure. Technical guide.
All right. Hey, I heard we got a new patent on processing the 5000 series material. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
We do, and I'm sure if anyone out there has seen as welded aluminum, they've probably seen this, which is shavings. And it's very typical with the 5000 series. You know, up until recently, everyone's wire produced shavings. We've developed a technology we've now patented that totally eliminates the shavings. When you get a plug liner, everyone's seen this too. You can see the little shavings that are generated. But what we've done is we treat the surface to remove oxides and to remove scale and scuff marks that clog the liner. They lodge themselves inside the liner, and then as the wire continues to pass through it, it tears out a little piece of wire. We've removed all that, and if our new product for the 5000 series MIG items, spools and drums, you no longer will get these shavings. It's been revolutionary. We've gained a lot of business by it. It's very differentiated, and it saves the end user a lot of money.
All right, thanks, Lance. Hey, let's talk a little bit about FlexCore wire. Dan, tell me a little bit about, I mentioned this X series. Tell me a little bit about this dual shield X series, the flux core wire. How's it different from everybody else's flux core wire?
Well, this is the most fun I can have is welding with the X series dual shield wire. It was originally brought to the market because of a customer survey where we found out from our fabricators and our welding shop owners that they were having problems finding qualified welders. And after we did a lot of research, we found out that there is a huge shortage of qualified welders. And not only that, but the average age of a welder today is 54 years old. And so when these guys go out looking for qualified welders, the pool is relatively small. So when they find a guy, it's really important that they get them up to speed quickly, that they can produce, they can make a weld that you're willing to put on a truck and ship to a customer. The X-Series wire has the attributes to let a less experienced welder get up to speed faster, produce a weld that's sellable or that you would be willing to present to your customer, and the The wire is helpful for a less experienced welder, but it also helps the more experienced welders. One thing we didn't want to do was build up the less experienced welder and slam Joe Varsity welder in the face. So these wires have a real broad operating range. You can weld a really pretty weld at the low end, a really pretty weld at the high end. Equal quality. So the X-Series wire helps us to help our customers get qualified welders, stay in business so that in the next generation we can be in business. Because without those guys, we're done.
Absolutely.
Well, you know, over the past couple of years, we've invested a tremendous amount of money in our chemistry labs, and but it's not all about the chemistry in the end. You know, you got to have the chemistry, but with flux core wires, there's just as much about selecting the right diameter, isn't there?
Yes, sir. Typically, when a customer engineers his welding procedure, he's going to lay out the weld thickness, the plate thickness, the joint design, all of the things that are particular heat input for that weld. And there are so many variables that it's sometimes difficult to identify what diameter of wire you need. A lot of it comes down to the skill level of the welder. The larger the diameter, the more difficult it is to weld. But I'm going to swing this back to the X-Series because I'm selfish. The X-Series, because of the wide operating range, gives us the ability to increase a diameter without making it more difficult for the operator. The range of the 045, the 052, and the 1/16 all overlap. Uh-huh. So when you're in the middle, they're relatively the same. So a guy that would normally say, my skill level won't let me weld a larger than an 045, and you give it to me and it will not work. With the X-Series, we give him a larger diameter, he welds faster, he puts in the same quality of weld with the same amount of skill.
Ah, interesting. That's really cool. Well, let's switch and talk a little bit about stick electrodes. Hey, Neil, you know, this Adamark brand has been powerful for us in North America here, and can you tell me a little bit about the original Adamark 7018 and then our latest Adamark 7018 Acclaim?
Sure, yeah. I mean, Adamark, everyone knows, a legendary brand. I mean, it's been around decades and decades. It's like the industry standard of 7018. However, you know, we listen to customers' feedback from them, and even though Adamark 7018 is as great as today as it was decades ago, you know, people still want some people want different attributes in an electrode. So we developed the Adamark Acclaim to address a few specific things such as arc initiation, out of position control, and just that entire puddle control that some welders have a different feel and style they want. And so we have the original Adamark 7018, and we developed Adamark 7018 Acclaim to address these other type of welders that have a different style and feel that they like. So, you know, there's a lot of different flavors that people like in food they eat, and even in electrodes, there's different flavors that people like. So we think we've addressed it with the standard 7018 and the new 7018 Acclaim.
And they both carry that famous Adamark name.
Absolutely, yes.
Well, that's not all they carry. Both of them also have the H4R categorization, and they also have Buy America on the package. Tell me, how important is that to the customer?
Well, both these things are very important. H4R is an AWS classification which designates 4 milliliters per 100 grams weld metal of hydrogen. So what that really means to you is very low moisture or hydrogen in the weld metal. And what that does is ensure a very sound weld metal, excellent mechanical properties, reduced hydrogen cold cracking, and depending on your procedure, it can be lower preheat. So that can save customers a lot of money if they don't have to preheat that weld metal, and if they don't have to worry about possible cracking and liability with their weld procedure. The other great thing is every Adamark electrode meets the Buy America criteria. And so what is Buy America? Buy America means the steel used in Adamark 7018 is melted in the USA, and all the steel used in Adamark electrodes are from American-made steel. So any customer that buys Adamark can feel comfortable if they're doing a government project, military, anything, any customer that says I gotta have a Buy America material to meet whatever his criteria, if it says Atomark, they're 100% guaranteed a piece Buy America.
That's fantastic. Listen, this has been great to have a little a chat here. You know, we didn't get a chance, we're running out of time, we didn't get a chance to talk about Purus, our newest solidware that has characteristics that make it optimal for robotic welding. It's our high-end product that reveals a weld with almost zero spatter, no silica islands. It's available in both a copper-coated and a non-copper-coated line. But, you know, we have so many things we could talk about. One thing we should tell you about is we've updated our welding handbook. And if you're here at FabTech, you can stop by and sign up to get a copy of it. And if you're not, you can go online, esop.com/fillermetals, and you can download the entire thing. It's got a tremendous amount of information in it, help you make your job easier, selecting the right product for the right application. But in any case, thanks for joining us here at FabTech, and we'll see you again soon.
Thanks, Ken.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yep.
Oh, is it right?